Hi, welcome to This Week in Property. I'm Jayashree Kurup, I'm editor of Magicbricks, and I have with me Prabhakar Sinha. He's the real estate editor of the Times of India. And a week that has seen the monetary policy, that has seen the budget, the interim budget presented, and a lot of small sops for the real estate sector. Before we go to the budget, Prabhakar, let's talk about the monetary policy. The biggest problem that the industry has been facing so far is the liquidity problem. And has the monetary policy eased it?
Exactly. They have eased it this time. Basically, they have changed their outlook from tightening of the liquidity to neutral.
Yeah.
And that means this entire, as the inflation has contained at around 4% and below 4%, so RBI this time has gone and taken a pro-growth stance.
Yeah.
And so they have not only cut the repo rate, which
yeah.
means that they have indicated banks to cut the lending rates,
yeah.
but also they have try to infuse liquidity in the system so that the more money could be available to the merchants or to the industries. And that is a very good thing, and particularly after a very long time, the RBI has taken this stand. So most of the bankers are welcoming it, and they are saying it that this is a welcome change and it is towards the pro-growth kind of a stance of RBI. It is very good.
A lot of the money for the real estate sector came from the NBFCs, which have been in a bit of a crisis in recent past. Has the monetary policy addressed that also?
No, monetary policy per se has not addressed that. But basically, monetary policy has asked banks to lend the NBFCs and continue to lend the NBFCs. Now, if that money is keep flowing to the NBFC, then certainly NBFC can on lend to the end users,
sure.
particularly the merchants or the industry. Right now, what had happened that as ILNFS had once it failed to repay its loan, and because of particularly the CP market, and that led to the entire crisis. But that was that one of a case. But that affected the entire NBFC sector. So now banks is trying to instill confidence among the RBI is trying to instill confidence among the banks so that they should continue to lend to NBFC.
Right.
And situation has started improving, except or besides.
Which was expected in by January that the situation will improve,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, now it has started improving. So the loans have become available. But only thing is this, that interest rate was high so far.
Mm-hmm.
Now with this indication that now lowering of the repo rate, RBI is also asking to lower the rate by the banks. But as the credit offtake has increased,
mm-hmm.
particularly this year, the total credit offtake has gone up by around more than 11%. So certainly that is tightening the situation a bit.
Mm-hmm.
So RBI will have to infuse some more capital or
yeah.
more liquidity in the system.
Right.
And I believe that it is systemic, and RBI will continue to do it as they have lowered the outlook or changed the outlook from tightening of the liquidity to neutral.
For the benefit of our consumers, let's explain to them what does the offtake of more credit by the market mean for the economy and for the real estate buyers?
So far what had happened in the last, say, couple of years, now the system, particularly the industries, are saddled with the overcapacity.
Yeah.
So they were not able to operate with full capacity, and they had taken the loan to build those capacity.
Yeah.
To service those loans, even after working at a 50% or 55% or 60% capacity, was tough. But in the last 3-4 years, as economy has grew, demand has grown, so the capacity utilization of this industry, of the entire industry, has gone up.
Yeah.
And now, according to the latest data, it is somewhere around 80%.
Yeah.
So now the credit, the industry requires money to put up additional or increase the capacity. So the investment is required by the private players also.
Yeah.
And because of this, because of the overcapacity in last 3-4 years, the private investment in the economy was very low,
yeah.
which has picked up this year.
Yeah.
This clearly indicates that now as the capacity utilization has gone up, so the industry wants more loans from the banks. Luckily at this time, as the entire system has geared up, so the inflation is low, other factors are also positive. So RBI is also trying to help that entire system. And with lowering of the repo rate, more credit flow will go into the industry, which has already gone up.
Yeah.
Last year it was 5-6%, which has already 5-6% means whatever loan was given last year, over and above that, 5-6% additional loan was given. This year it has gone up to more than 11%.
Right.
So the credit offtake is increasing, and that will fuel the economic activity also, and so the GDP growth also.
Right.
This is a very good cycle. Particularly, this is going to create a very positive environment in the system. New jobs will be created. And more than that, when the new jobs are created, then the existing people, existing job are filled, they will feel more secured.
Right.
And because of that, an environment should be created where the people will be ready to take the exposure of this kind of a loan to buy a house.
Right, right.
So that is my feeling is here, that with this kind of scenario, with this kind of improvement in the system, it's a systemic improvement basically,
yeah.
The demand for housing, particularly given the price which is at is today,
yeah.
The demand for housing are likely to go up substantially this year and the next year.
Also, now let's go to the budget. The budget has also tried to get the consumers to lighten their wallets, buy more houses. The notional rent on second homes has gone away, both for the consumer and for the developer. There is no vacancy tax, so to speak, right?
Yeah, exactly. Now, earlier what has happened that, particularly for the individual buyers. Now, if I have a house, say, in somewhere in Noida, and I bought another house in Gurgaon, because say, my wife is working in Gurgaon and I am working in Noida. Now, if my family has a two house, then what happens that the one house, only I can claim the no rental or no income through rentals in one house. For another house, there will be a deemed rental. Even if
you hadn't given it on rent.
Given it on rent. Even if I am living there or not, doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Even if I have locked it, I'll have to take it as a rental income of that house as a deemed income, and say suppose it is 20,000 rupees per month of that area.
Mm-hmm.
So 2,40,000 rupees will be added to my income, and so I'll have to pay tax if I'm at a 30% tax bracket.
Yeah.
Say on that I'll have to pay at the 30%, and this, that means 60,000 to 12,000, 72,000 rupees as a tax I should pay it.
Yeah.
Now if suppose the rental is higher, then the tax outgo should be higher.
Yeah.
So this was a huge burden. So now in this, particularly today, when the people are buying some second houses, but they don't want to give on rent because of various factors, and particularly because of uncertainty whether you can get your house vacated by the tenants or not.
Because the rental norms have not been corrected for
exactly.
a long time.
So the people are not now investing in the second house. And another point also, that earlier, there was a, under 24-1B, there was a system where if you have bought a house, second house or third house, as an investment, then the entire outgo as EMI, as an interest, was deducted from your total income, from your taxable income.
Yeah.
So that means that, and your the tax liability will go down. Now, even if suppose you are earning a rental of say 2% of the capital value, and you are paying an interest at 8.5%, still you are gaining around 6.5% every month.
Yeah.
And you are getting a deduction from the tax liability.
Yeah.
So 30% of 6.5%, something around 2%, you are saving. But that system has gone out.
Yeah.
That system is not there now.
Yeah.
So that means now on the second house purchase, you are not going to get any capital benefit.
Yeah.
You are not going to get any incentive on the rental income also.
Yeah.
You have to pay the deemed income, taking as a rent as a deemed income. So it was a big disincentive to purchase.
This was in the last few years.
Till the before this budget.
Yeah.
So now this budget, at least they have said it, that you can buy second house in the system, in the area also. And that even if you will keep that house locked, then the deemed income or the rental of that house cannot be treated or should not be treated as a deemed income.
Right.
But if you keep it on rent, certainly that will be a
income. Right. So if you buy a second house and you give it on rent, of course you have to pay your taxes. But if you've bought the second house and you keep it for self-use or your future self-use, or you don't choose to give it out on rent, there is no notional rent on which you have to pay your taxes.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah, yeah.
Now, the second thing is that the developers have they have another additional year.
Yeah, this was a big demand for the developers. Yes. And this was really bad, what they had done it. Now, basically, now when developers have suppose have constructed 600 apartments, out of that they could sell it only 200 apartments. 400 apartments are unsold, it is inventory. So basically that is, I mean that 400 apartments, and they are not able to sell it because market is not picking it up.
Right.
Now according to the rule earlier, even after getting the completion certificate, they had to take the rental income of deemed rental income as the income and they'll have to pay tax.
Right. They have given 1 year.
Last year.
Yeah.
Last year only they had given it 1 year.
Yeah.
That okay fine, till 1 year you will not have to pay it.
Yeah.
But after 1 year you'll have to pay it. Now there are many developers and particularly in the remote areas, say the smaller towns, say in Bhopal, Jalandhar, Ludhiana, and all these areas. There are developers who are saddled with this kind of inventory for the last 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, and they are not able to sell it.
Right.
And at the same time, government is saying it that whatever rental, deemed rental of that area, according to that, they will calculate that the rental of that entire area and take it as the income of the developer and charge tax on that.
Right.
So they said it, ki boss, it is very difficult to survive in this kind of a situation.
Especially because the market conditions were slow. Buyers are, there are fewer buyers than before.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So now this time at least what they have done it, that up to 2 years after getting the completion certificate, up to 2 years, they will not have to pay this deemed income tax on the deemed income, but they can keep it. But after 2 years, again, they'll have to pay it.
Right.
Now, thing is this, that this is a stock in trade, basically.
Yeah.
For them,
yeah.
This is a stock in trade.
Yeah.
Now, ideally, it should not be charged for the tax at all.
Right.
But the government is still forcing it. And at the same time, I mean, if they will sell it at a lower than the circle rate price, then again that is prohibited.
Yes, because of the income tax.
Income tax authority.
Yes.
They are saying that the differential of that amount, the circle rate calculated on the basis of the circle rate and the market rate, the difference will be treated as the income for both the side.
Right.
And they will be taxed.
Yes. So on both sides they were being squeezed.
Yeah.
Now this is good for the market, right?
This is a no, but
now let's talk about what's how it will impact the consumer, because we got a large number of consumers out there. The one thing that's happening is that the consumer got a lot of stay in my house free of rent for the next 1 year. That kind of schemes had come in across the India. Many developers had started giving houses on rent without on a rent free period. That those schemes will stop, right?
Now two things. Now like some of the developers in Delhi, what have they done? That they are saying it that I will give you the flat on the basis of ready to move in, but that might not be your own flat.
Yeah.
So I will give you a flat to live right now, which is completed.
Yeah.
And your chosen one, whenever that will be completed, I will shift you to that once the completion is secured of that apartment.
Yeah.
So during this period, I mean certainly the developer is asking you to live or requesting you to live in that completed house, and so the rental income of that house should be treated, it should be calculated, and it should be the liability of the person who is living in that to pay the tax on that.
Right.
Because that is his income.
Yeah, yeah, sure. Now, consumers, there are two ways this budget has helped you. One, it has reduced the your liability on the second house that you buy. It has also put, the monetary policy is likely to put a little more money into your wallet. The developers, it has eased the scenario considerably, and the developers should be able to do their sales better,
budget,
right?
The budget also has been said that in the GST also, they have already asked the council to consider lowering the GST rate also. And that is also part of the budget. So that means that is also likely to come very soon. So So overall, the government is trying to push the real estate sector to drive growth in the economy.
Right.
And they have used the budget also, particularly now suppose as the income tax up to the income of 5 lakh rupees is completely free now. So that means the additional 12,000 rupees will come to the pocket of the buyers, the taxpayers. Besides that, the standard deduction has gone up from 40,000 to 50,000 rupees. So 10,000 rupees additional tax on that will be saved. So substantial savings have been made, have been allowed in this, particularly in this budget. So this is a very good budget, particularly from the consumer point of view, because a lot of money has been given to the consumers, and that I believe should drive the demand for the housing sectors and very soon.
And the housing sector is today on a rise. It has, I think, reached the lowest ebb that it was on in the last year.
Now, not only this, now I was just talking to somebody in Chandigarh, and they are saying that in Chandigarh, in the last 6 months, prices have gone up by 15%.
Yeah.
Because now the people have started buying, and as the prices have started taking U-turn, so more and more purchases are happening. And so one developer was telling me that earlier he was not able to sell even 20 crore rupees worth every month of apartments. Now today the total sale proceeds he is getting is around 50 crores.
Yeah.
So that is quite substantial jump. Right now the prices have not gone up, but very soon the developer ultimately, when the demand will pick up, then developer will certainly increase the price. So I believe that this could be the right time. Right now at least you can negotiate with the developer. And you can negotiate for a better size of the better flat, better position, location of the flat at the same price. But I believe in the next 6 months, you will not have that kind of a maneuver.
Depending on market to market. If you take markets like the NCR, where actually there is the projects were launched over a period of time. But all the projects came up to a point and there was a complete standstill in the market, which is when RERA, GST, Benami, there were so many acts that came into being. Because of which, and especially because of RERA, developers have certainly started building their apartments and handing it over, because the penalty for delay is very high. And because all developers have started building at the same time, Prabhakar, we've seen so much supply. And that is intense supply in different markets.
But this is happening for the last 6 months.
Yes.
And the people are picking it up.
Yes. And today, but what we've noticed is that the consumer has been buying. The consumer and the consumer is not an investor so per se, but a consumer is a end user who, because prices are low, because money is there for the taking, and the consumers have started buying. They've taken more time to buy. We've noticed that on Magicbricks, we've noticed that from a 2 to 3 time visit, the consumers have been visiting us 6 to 7 times, which means that double the number of times and double the number of period, but they were still buying.
Because his negotiating space has increased quite substantially.
Absolutely.
Now today the developer starts from 4500 rupees per square feet and they can come down to 3500 rupees per square feet.
Right.
So the buyers are also very intelligent, and they are, and that is good also.
That is good for the market.
Good for the market also. And they are squeezing the developer. But right now what I am saying is this, that as soon as these projects are completed and sold out, then in the secondary, right now the secondary market is also coming.
Yeah.
I mean, the people who have invested 7-8 years back, now they want to exit.
Yes.
Despite the fact that they are not making much money, but they still they want to exit.
Yeah.
Now, if those stocks are over, and I believe that in the next 6 to 1 year's time, particularly those stocks, particularly the good located stocks will be finished. And then after the prices will start inching up, even in NCR.
Right. And therefore, you have a window of another 6 months to a year when you still have the luxury of looking around, searching, negotiating and buying your property. So, consumers, we'd like to tell you that there is a poll running on our site. Do keep taking the poll. What we did ask you is, did the exemption of notional tax help you? Please continue to take our poll, because we're going to be announcing the results soon and start the next poll soon. Let's go to a few of the queries that have started coming, Prabhakar. We spend more time discussing because there are a lot of policies that came out and a lot of things that will impact you. Now, one thing that we did not speak about, and that's what our consumer has started with, there's Satish Sheravath who says, what is the scope in Delhi and land pooling areas?
No, land pooling area, still government has to do a lot of work at the policy level before they will announce it and before it will take, it will really take off. So, right now the last mile, the final policy that who will be the authority, where it has to be applied and how it has to be gone about has not come about. So I believe that that is likely to come, but right now as again the entire country has gone into election mode, so you will have to wait for another 3-4 months at least before this entire process will restart, and only after that things will start moving. But right now, even today, lot many developers, lot many builders are offering their apartments, saying it that we got the permission, DDA is approved, kind of a thing.
But DDA has not approved.
Nothing, so that sort of is there in the market today.
In fact, you must understand the whole planning process. Right now, what DDA has done is opened a portal where the farmers and the landowners can come and list their property saying, I'm interested in pooling my land. Once this is open for how long, Prabhakar? I think they've, it's a limited time, 6 months if I'm not mistaken, after which DDA will take stock of how much pooled land has come into the market. The planning process, the demarcation of the sectors
sector,
will
happen, and then after, in every sector there will be one consortium and all the pooled land will go to that consortium. And now if you want
for planning,
for the planning, then the consortium will plan it with the DDA, that how that sector will be developed, demarcated, and then after the land will be redistributed again to the landowners.
Right. In a 60-40 ratio, where the landowner gets 60% and 40% goes to DDA for common area, common facilities.
50-50, whatever it is. So it has to go like that. Yeah. And then only after that, only after land is received by the original owner, then the construction can start. So it will take a lot of time. It is
a good 2 years away, don't you think?
At least
2 years away. Yes, there are supposed to be about 17 lakh housing that should come up.
Yeah, they are saying.
About 17 lakh housing is expected to come, but it's going to be over the next start only after
20
about
years.
Yeah, next 20 years, and it will start only in another 2 years or so.
Because right now, DDA will have to also develop infrastructure, water supply, electricity supply, road connectivity also has to be strengthened. So all those sort of things has to be done. Only after that, the construction site will be started developing.
And so remember that a very large area, how many hectares is this whole pooled area?
Huge area, around 30,000 or 40,000 acres, something like that.
Now, for that volume of housing, of area to be developed, facilities given, civic amenities, planning happening, it takes a long time. So, please don't be in a hurry. And for anyone who says that this is approved projects, remember there are no approved projects. They're duping you. We believe that over a lakh of people have invested in various housing schemes. And these are all Ponzi schemes. Unless they get the land and they know where the land is, I don't think anyone can say that the policy has played itself out. One quick announcement, that we ran a poll: will exemption of notional tax on second housing help owners? And an overwhelming 89% says yes. 11% says no. So thank you for participating in our poll. Our next poll is, has budget 2019 lowered your tax liabilities? Do take part in the poll. These polls help us understand whether what your mood is, how you are responding to policy. Let's go on to our next query, Prabhakar. There's Mohit Singh of Delhi who says, how will the extension of Section 80IBA benefits help affordable housing and those planning to buy such units in the Delhi NCR?
Now, this is greatly, in fact, help the developers or the market also. Because 80IBA, what happens in that, now if a developer has developed one project of affordable housing, that means that all the units should be less than of 60 square meter carpet area. Now, if that construction has been completed, project is completed and sold out, then whatever profit is made in that project by the developer, that profit is tax-free for him.
Right.
So he has not to pay any tax.
So it's a big incentive for developers to build in this segment.
Exactly. Because normally, even if suppose a 100 crores project and the profit is, let's say, 8% or 10%, so 8 to 10 crore profit, and out of that 30% or 35%, 30% of that means at least 3 crore is saved by the developer. So it's a huge sum they are developing, saving it out of that. So basically this, now the government this time what they have done it, that earlier this entire scheme was up to 2019 only.
Yeah.
So they have extended the date now up to 2020. Whatever, so any project which is registered till 2020 will
approved by March.
By 2020 March. The
developer will get the tax incentive.
Tax benefit.
So it is actually, if you look at the when the housing market went into a crisis, every developer was building in the premium segment and the lower segments were being neglected. The government clearly feels that affordable housing is the way to go because that is the unmet segment of demand. And therefore, they are incentivizing the builders to build in that segment where the consumer demand is. And this is really good for the market, and this should be able to meet the 2022.
Yeah, and besides that, on the GST front also, at present also, the normal housing GST is 12%, okay? In the affordable housing, GST is 8% only. So, if you calculate that entire thing for affordable housing, the net tax at the GST level is nil, or at least 1% to 2%. Now, right now when the government is talking about the revising the GST rate, then they are thinking to bring down 12% to 8% and 8% to 5%. That means the final GST tax on the housing is almost nil.
Yeah.
So that is a great, benefit to the affordable housing. And particularly the whole effort of this government is to push the affordable housing so that it can achieve housing for all by 2022.
Yes. And actually, this is the best time that till 2022, there are so many policies that are pushing for housing that you can afford, that for anyone who has a small budget, you should keep looking, you should be very active in the market, keep searching. You're not in a hurry. You have 6 months to a year before the market start looking up. But this is a good time for you to start looking for your property. And if you find the right property, buy it. Because like Prabhakar said, the premium units in every project, there will be some units which are in the corners, which are south facing, which are in demand. And those units start going out of the market first. So you have to take the leftover units if you keep waiting for the prices to drop to the lowest ebb.
And
right?
Particularly now, if the people are thinking that I'll buy once the interest rate will fall down. Look. Today, the banks are lending at variable interest rate. Now, suppose today you take a loan at 9.5%. Now, after 6 months, say the loan interest rate comes down to 8.5%. That benefit will pass on to you also. But if you will wait for the interest rate to fall first, then to buy, then as soon as the interest rate will fall, demand will certainly perk up and the prices of housing also will go up. So, on the net, the benefit I have seen in the last 20 years, that the fall of the interest rate, only those can take who takes the plunge before the fall of the interest rate.
In fact, it's a sentiment issue.
Exactly.
Real estate works on sentiment, and a lot of people who are holding back today are holding back thinking that the prices will come down further. One of the things that both Prabhakar and I have been doing deep research into, the price at which the projects are being sold, each unit is being sold across NCR and a lot of markets, are very close to the cost price, the amount it takes for the developer to buy the land, build the property. And
lower than the cost price, in fact. Today, the many of the developers are selling, if you will go under construction projects, say 90% constructed or 100% constructed, even fully constructed house, let me tell you this, the most of the houses are sold at the below the replacement cost, that means the cost of the construction of the
Because there is a holding cost that the developer has to incur, and he would rather see the project moving.
And the short of liquidity.
And the short of liquidity.
He has to manage their other liability also, he has to repay the loan, he has to pay the interest. So they are in the deep problem.
Yes. And therefore, this is a good time for you to enter the market. There's another query about ATIB. There's Nitin Garg from Gurgaon who says, I'm a salaried individual and planning to buy a house for investment. Will Section ATIB benefit revive the ailing housing market? Actually, it's revived. I would call it a revived market today. It's not a beleaguered market. It is a market where you are seeing a lot of sales. You're not seeing prices go up, and we don't expect prices to go up for another 6 to 8 months. But in certain markets, it may go a little beyond that. But that all depends on whether there is jobs creation in that market, whether there's ailing market, right?
No, certainly not a ailing market. And number two, that when one wants to buy a house for investment, then he must try to understand that which market is poised to grow. Now, if he'll buy certain market where the prices are already high or relatively higher, or some other area which is coming up in the nearby area, so then the prices might not appreciate in the next 3, 4, 5 years also. So you'll have to think of it before making any investment in real estate sector. You must do the recce, you must do the proper research, then only you invest. Today the market is good for the end users, because this is the market. It will not go below this, but whether it will go up from here, say 30% or 100% or 200%, I mean, nobody can say this.
And one thing that we keep telling investors, of course, there are very few investors in the market, but if you are planning to invest in the real estate market, follow the jobs. Wherever there are jobs, there is potential. Right? Let's go to Arun Kumar of Noida, who says, what exactly is the benefit given by the government in the budget by extending the Section 80IB benefit for another year? Prabhakar, you
want
to explain?
No, this is for the developer base. 80IB benefit, look, it will come to the end users indirectly. The benefit is directly to the developer, that if a developer develops affordable housing projects, then the profit earned in that project will be tax-free. So what happens that because of that is tax-free, so developers build in that entire thing in the cost structure itself, lowering the price further. And that is why the affordable housing today is now a project or affordable housing unit in a affordable housing project is cheaper than the similar project in the other project which is not come under the affordable housing project. Because under 80IB a benefit, if one wants to take, then all the units should be of the less than 60 square meter. And suppose there are a project which is where the all kind of a units are there, in that unit, even if you will buy a smaller size of flat, you may not get that developer will not get the 80IB benefit. So indirectly, you will also not get the benefit of that price cut or the price lowering of the price because of ATIBA.
Sure.
So that is the difference.
Let's go to Dinesh Mehta of Greater Noida. Will property be more affordable now as the budget gives exemption of tax on notional rental income from unsold inventory? What benefit will a buyer or a developer get in this?
Now, today, look, the prices will come down or go up. It's not directly linked to this. In fact, because of this, the demand for housing will go up. So it should revive the entire market. Now, today, if you want to buy or if you have bought another house in the same city, then for the another house, you will have to pay tax on the rental income of that house. Till today, you might not be paying it, you might not be showing it that whether there is a deemed income on that house or not. But legally, that is not the correct position.
Right.
You must show that how much the deemed income or deemed rental income of that house, and that should be included in your total income, and the tax accordingly has to be paid on that. Now the government has said this time, that if you have second house, still you can continue, if you want to lock it, then you need not pay that additional tax on that or the additional tax on the deemed income of that house. But if you'll give that house on rent, certainly the rental income will be included in your total income and you'll have to pay tax on that. So this is the only benefit, that now deemed income will not be treated as your income. Earlier, for the second house also, the deemed income was there. Now if you have more than two houses, then for the third house, that income will be treated as deemed income of that rental income of that house will be treated as your income and you'll have to pay tax on that. So it is a savings for the owner of the house. It is not the saving for the developer or any other party. So,
actually, I would like to hear say that the deemed income provision came because the government of India did a study about 4 years ago and found that there were about 11 million vacant houses. Now, if India was struggling to house its people, but there were 11 million houses that were ready but unoccupied, the government of India felt that there has to be an incentive to get people to put their houses back on rent. Now, the one thing that has not happened is that there has not been a tweaking of rental policy at a national level. Of course, some states, Haryana has made some changes, Tamil Nadu has made some changes, positive changes at that. But the government is seized of the fact that you do need some amount of rental housing, and therefore they felt that squeezing the consumer meant that not enough people with money in their pockets were buying houses which could later go into the rental market.
Yeah.
Therefore, if you free that second house from rental income, that means that the where the developer is saddled with large volumes of houses that are not selling, at least it pushes the market and gives the sentiment the right push.
It will create demand.
It will create demand. And that demand, which was withholding itself because there was a
disincentive.
Yeah,
there's to buy a second house. Because even if you have locked that house, you'll have to pay tax on the deemed rental of that house. Now, that is huge sometimes.
That is huge, especially in areas where the rental is very high. And the consumer who has spent money buying the house, thinking that there would be a rental income, or maybe because you want to maintain two establishments, or for future end use, those people stopped buying because there was a big disincentive. The disincentive has been removed.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. There's Karan Sharma of Pune who says he has a 2 BHK flat which he's not able to rent out to a tenant for the past 6 months. How will the tax exemption on notional rental on non-leased house property in budget 2019 help owners like me? In fact,
now for this gentleman, he can understand very easily.
Yes.
Now, if this house is your second house, then so far you should have paid tax on the deemed rental income of that house.
For the last 6 months when he did not lease it out.
Not lease the house.
Yeah.
But now, even if you have not leased out that house, there will be no deemed income included in your total income to calculate the tax liability.
Absolutely.
So now it is completely tax-free. You need not worry about that. You should not include that at all. So, but provided you have not given it on rent.
Yeah.
The moment the rental income will come, you will have to include it in your total tax.
So, there is no tax on notional income, but when there is actual income, of course, you have to pay your taxes. There's Aruna Rao of Mumbai who says, we have our own property in Delhi, but we live in a rental house in Mumbai with our son. Are we going to get the tax exemption for our property in Delhi? If that was the only property you
then
owned,
you
there was never a tax on you. It was only for the second house.
And if you have locked it.
Yeah.
But even if you have given it on rent, then certainly that rental income will be your taxable income, and but at the same time you will get the HRA also, housing rent allowance in your Bombay, because there you are paying the rent, and here the rent will be your income. But now as you but if you don't want to give it on rent, then there will be no deemed rental income for your house.
Vineet Kumar of Bangalore says, budget gives exemption on long-term capital gains from sale of house which can now be invested for purchasing two properties. How will this be applicable and actually help buyers selling and buying? In fact, this is one of the very good provisions of this budget and a long-standing demand.
Long-standing demand.
Why don't you explain the details
now,
of this?
What had happened earlier that many people now who have come in large city much earlier, and suppose he has bought a house in Friends Colony or in some good area, and today he has two children. Now he wants to sell that property to buy two houses so that he can give the two houses to their two sons. Now so far what was happening, that even if you sell that house say for 5 crore and you can buy two houses for 2.5 crore or 2 crore each, but you cannot buy, you can buy two or three, whatever you wish to, but the tax liability will be treated as such that from the capital gains on sale of the first property should be used to buy only one house. Now, whatever amount he used to buy one house, that amount will not be taxable under 54EA. But for the second house, even if suppose out of that 5 crore, you bought one house for 3 crore, so that 3 crore will be used up, and so you will not have to pay tax on that. But on the rest 2 crore amount, if you have taken, you'll have to pay the capital gains from the sale of the first house at the 20% rate, and then only you can invest in the second house. Today, that provision has gone. Now they are saying it that on the sale of one house, you can buy two houses using your entire capital gains. So that means that you can use that money to buy two houses and you can, you can relieve yourself from paying any tax on that.
Right.
So that would be a huge saving for you.
And this is up to 2 crore.
This is up to 2 crore.
The capital gains that should have been up to 2 crore. There's Soumya Chakrabarty of
course. And only once in the lifetime.
And once in a lifetime. Which means that it is not that you keep buying and selling and then buying two houses.
Yeah.
It is only to facilitate those people who wanted to sell a house. For instance, you bought in about 20 years ago and now your children are grown up and you want to sell it and give one house each to both your children or something like that. It's allowing you to buy two houses. And this was the demand that this that all sectors had made to the government, and they've just listened to that demand. There is Soumya Chakrabarty of Kolkata who says, how will the delivery of house and price be taken care of after budget 2019? Will it be cheaper for home buyers now after some tax sops given by the government? There are two things he's asking. One is delivery of house, two is price of the house. Both of delivery we can understand, but price of the house the government will not fix. What it does is give you means in which you can reduce the cost of the house for yourself.
Yeah, and if the supply increases, well, certainly the price falls, and the demand increases, price also goes up. So it's matched. It's the market activity. But the supply, but the completion and the delivery, I believe that government has done lot many things, particularly the RERA and CLT. Lot many forces are working to complete the projects today. And developers are also very hard pressed to complete the project. They are doing it, but as such, there is no announcement to expedite the completion of a project today.
Right, Prabhakar, I wanted to actually pick up the issues, a couple of issues. When consumers buy a house, what are the five things, for instance, they should keep in mind when they look for the house? Because we are talking to end consumers, and today, because a budget came, because a monetary policy came, we are talking about those things that have impacted your buy. And going by Soumya Chakrabarty's query, I think a lot of consumers are expecting that government moves push them into buying houses. That's not true.
It's not true.
What is happening, Soumya?
Government is facilitating you to buy a house at affordable price. Basically, government wants to keep the price of the house at affordable range. And besides that, they are prompting you to buy, and so they want you to own a house for your security. That will change your entire activities also, your behavior also. So it is good for the society that everybody has a house. And for that sake only, government tries to promote that one should go to buy a house and to buy a house. And for that, they give certain benefits to buy a house. And that any society does, and so the Indian government also is promoting
that. And the important thing here is that the government has brought out policies like RERA, which have pushed the entire market into completing its projects. No developer today can delay housing. They have to deliver on time, and they have to deliver quality projects on time. Because there is within the first 5 years, if there's any service or structural defect, the developer is liable to compensate the consumer and rectify it for him. Which means that you'll get good houses, you'll get timely delivery of houses, and also now, because sentiment has been weak for a while, I think there are efforts to, and the economy is doing performing fairly well, which is why the government has a little more leeway to play around with policy.
Yeah.
Like we said in the beginning, one is that the government, the inflation is, the pressure of inflation is not there. Therefore, the RBI could ease the
money supply.
The second thing is that it could, the developers have started delivering. And there is no doubt about it. Across the country, we can see that there is delivery of houses that is happening. If that is so, the government says that because there is some positive in the market, let's give it another push and see whether the so the ATI, and clearly the shortfall is in the affordable category, and the government's entire policy push is to make affordable housing. housing up to 60 square meters carpet area, which is not a very small house. 60 square meters carpet area normally comes out to about 1,000 square feet?
Yeah, 900 square feet.
900 square feet, which was more or less the size of the development authority houses. If you look at in the 80s and 90s, yeah, yeah, the DDA, the GDA, the BDA houses that MIG, came out.
HIG used to be of that size.
That's right. And HIG used to be of that size. Therefore, you can see that this housing that they're pushing is the housing that was that had the maximum take up by the middle classes. And today, every effort is to make the middle classes be able to afford the housing. The middle income families are the drivers of the economy, and the lower middle income and the upper middle income are both being taken care of in the
on
government.
On the taxation
policy
side also, you see the tax liability or the income of 5 lakh of rupees, yes, is completely done away with.
Yes, which means so there's more money in your wallet too.
More money in your wallet, yeah, exactly. So the government is trying to push. And now 5,000 rupees income, now if he buys a house and suppose he pays an interest say of 150,000 rupees per annum, so total income goes up to 650,000 rupees. So that means that 55,000 rupees per month kind of a income is today tax free.
Yes.
So this is a very good,
yes, yes, absolutely,
move by the government.
And that means 6.5 lakhs, even 7 lakhs, if you are saving, you
up to 10 lakh. If you start savings and including everything, then it can go up to 10 lakh of rupees.
So even if you earn 10 lakh of rupees, you can get out of the tax net.
Exactly.
Because you're saving money, you're buying a house, you're getting the tax relief from that. Everything included, up to 10 lakhs is what Prabhakar's estimate is that you can actually be on zero tax.
Yeah. And 10,50,000, I had calculated once.
So 10,50,000 is a reasonably good income. Now, if it is a family income, two people earning 10 lakh, we have a very large body of people. And that is the body of people that the government wants to help own a house. We've got our last two queries here. There is Anil Singh of Delhi who says, large residential properties with historic values made it very difficult for owners to sell and create multiple assets. Will this change now? Of course.
Of course, it will change.
This is that capital gains thing.
Benefit that was given to you.
Remember that when you sell and when you talk about very large residential properties, remember that it is capped at 2 crore.
Yeah.
Your capital gains benefit has to be 2 crore for you to be able to buy two houses and save on the capital gains.
Well, capital gains up to rupees 2 crore. Now, yeah, if he has, suppose, capital gains of 5 crores,
yeah,
then up to 2 crore can be reinvested in the housing property for two housing property. And there will be no tax on that, but on just 3 crore, he'll have to pay tax.
Either pay tax or save the money, right?
No, no, you'll have to pay.
You'll have to pay tax. If you claim the benefit, then you'll have to pay tax. Mukesh of Mumbai says, how will self-employed individuals get benefit in terms of availing home loans and getting tax benefits as home buyers? I think that is the...
First of all, he must understand it, that interest paid on house, interest paid on the loan taken to buy a house, first house particularly, one gets a tax benefit up to 150,000 rupees.
Yes.
Okay. Whether he is salaried, whether he is non-salaried, whether he has his own business. Plus, if his total, the purchase of the house is up to 50 lakh of rupees, and if that is his first house, then his benefit can go up to 2 lakh of rupees. Okay. So, this is for both, for the salaried and non-salaried, for both. So, even if suppose he is doing his own business, he can buy a house and can save tax very easily.
Right. In fact, whether you are a salaried individual or a non-salaried individual, today in the digital economy, whatever earnings you get and whatever taxes you're paying is all being linked to your PAN and so on.
Yeah,
and there is whatever earnings you get, it's the cash economy is slowly coming down and you're going into a more formal economy. Whether you're self-employed or employed in any organization, the amount of money that comes to you is what you pay your income taxes on. And therefore, whether self-employed or otherwise, you will be able to get the benefit. And that's where we're going to close this. But before I close this session, I wanted to tell you that our second poll, has budget 2019 lowered your tax liabilities? 80% has said yes and 20% says no. Therefore,
those 20% must be... Over the 5 lakh rupees.
Absolutely. People who are over the 5 lakh rupees or who are buying very large housing,
yeah,
and they are the ones who may not have got. But the average, the aam janta, the general people have found have been benefited by the budget 2019 as well as the monetary policy. Clearly a directional budget. The direction that has been pointed is that housing for all should be a success. Whether this government wins election 2019 or not, what it's done is given a direction that housing for all must be a...
That's a huge, huge slogan and huge mission.
That's
and
right.
If the country achieves that, I'm telling you that entire behavior pattern of the people will change.
Absolutely, absolutely. Ownership of housing is something that gives a lot of security in a country that where social security is not a norm. These are the things that will ensure that there is less homelessness, less number of people who are outside any kind of safety net.
Yeah, owning a house is a huge thing.
Yeah.
I mean, a country like poor country like in India. At least you have a roof to live.
Yes. And thank you so much for watching This Week in Property. I'm Jayashree Kurup and this is Prabhakar Sinha.
Thank you.
Please subscribe to Magicbricks on YouTube and click the bell icon to get new videos.